Today what we're doing is we're removing the tooth number 8. Number 8, I don't know if you can see this on the video, but number 8 has this groove here. It's a very slight groove. But she had not had a pocket before and has developed this really deep pocket here. And it's following this groove. It's probably fractured now. So we're going to be doing an immediate implant and a provisional thing now. Okay, force it. You alright?
Do you want me to turn off the recorder or leave it on?
Fracture that kind of started from this developmental groove on the lingual and then just boom, went all the way up. More recently I had probed it at 6 millimeters, but today I was probing even deeper. I went to Kirk Pasquinelli's talk. Yeah, it was really, really good. He's starting to do Alloderm now. It's interesting, all these people who swore that they would never do Alloderm.
They're doing it now.
Yeah.
They've been watching your videos.
Well, not enough.
I'm just kidding.
No, not those guys, but, you know, other people are. Which is good. I've had 769,000 views now.
Uh-huh.
And I have 162 subscribers.
That's excellent.
Yeah, it's great. A lot of vibration now. You can see we're starting our osteotomy toward along the palatal cortex, and because that's pretty hard bone, we'll be using that edge as the palatal edge of the implant placement. So this is our osteotomy. We've got really good walls on the mesial, distal, and palatal, and at the apical end we're good here. We're going to be bone grafting the space defect on the facial, which is typical, and probably have to profile the bone before we start making our provisional. Got a 4.513 implant direct internal hex. Putting the guide on the bone profiler now. So. Okay, so we got our site bone grafting, now we're going to make the provisional. Okay, so what we've done so far is we've prepped the abutment using the short screw that will eventually go in there, because this is an implant direct system. And then what I've also done is I take my polycarbonate crown and I've trimmed the gingival margin area and then made a hole for my screw. Take the inside of the polycarbonate shell and line it with some methylmethacrylate acrylic monomer. So I just kind of take some pickups and break the composite, pull this out, and go ahead and bite together. See, we're out of occlusion here, and then go ahead and very slowly slide straight forward. Okay, so that's our implant positional, and take a look at it in a couple weeks. Okay, this is the 3-week healing of the immediate implant and provisional in the number 8 side. Okay, so here's our x-ray, and take a little closer look. So this is the 3-month post-op of the immediate implant and provisional on tooth number 8. This is the final restoration on the implant on tooth number 8. You can see that there's some marginal inflammation, and then when I look closer, there's a little fistula on the facial here, right here, and it's going to the margin of the crown. Now I went and looked in there, or felt around in there, and I couldn't, there wasn't anything that I could feel in there, but what we're going to do is we're going to use some local anesthetic and look in there with the endoscope. This is a snapshot of the cement found subgingivally with the perioscope, seen on the x-ray and after removal. This is our initial x-ray with radiographic marker, the immediate implant and provisional, and the final restoration.